Hi guys, I'm Suprabha. In previous video, we saw two examples based on linear algebra for civil engineering. In this video, we'll see two more examples. Let us start with the first example. It says, rank of matrix is, elements are 1, 1, 0, minus 2, 2, 0, 2, 2, 1, 4, sorry, 4, 1, 3, 1. And the options are 1, 2, 3 and 4. Before we proceed, we know what is rank of matrix. In one of the video tutorial, we had studied that the number of linearly independent rows or columns gives us the rank of matrix. Also, we had studied how to find out the rank of matrix. There are two methods. First is determinant method and second is using elementary operation method. Now we know determinant method only applies for square matrices. As the given matrix is rectangular matrix, we need to switch to elementary operation. So let us perform the elementary operations. What I'll do is, I'll simultaneously apply elementary operation on row 2 and row 3. You can do it separately as well. So first elementary operation that will be performed is, if I multiply 4 to the element 1 of row 1 and subtract it, will get 0. So the operation will be R3 minus 4 into R1. Similarly, if we multiply 2 to 1 and subtract it, the element here will be 0. So elementary operation for row 2 will be R2 minus 2R1. So let us see what is the resulting matrix. The first row will remain as it is, 1, 1, 0, minus 2. See the row 2. Row 2, R2 minus, the first element is 2, minus 2 into 1. This will be 0. The next element is 0 minus 2 into 1. That will be minus 2. Next element is 2, minus 2 into 0. This will be 2. And the last element is 2 minus 2 into minus 2. This will be 4 and this will give us 6. Let us perform the elementary operations on row 3. First element is 4. 4 minus 4 into 1, that gives 0. Next is 1 minus 4 into 1, that is minus 3. Third element is 3 minus 4 into 0, that will give 3. And the last element is 1 minus 4 into minus 2. This will give 9. So this is the resulting matrix. Now if you see row 2 and row 3, elementary operations can be performed on row 3. We need to find out the factor. So let us consider minus 3. We don't know the factor that can be multiplied to minus 2. That will give this element equal to 0. So we'll assume that equal to x minus 2 equal to 0. Okay, let us see what is that unknown factor. So this will be minus 2x equal to 3. X is minus 3 by 2. So the elementary operation that is performed on row 3 will be R3, the factor is minus 3 by 2, so minus 3 by 2 R2. Okay, let us see what is the resulting matrix now. As elementary operation is performed only on row 3, first two rows will remain as it is, 1, 1, 0, minus 2. 0, minus 2, 2, 6. R3 is 0. 0 minus 3 by 2 into 0 will give us 0. We will directly write that. See the next factor now. Minus 3. Minus 3 by 2. The R2 now here is minus 2. This cancels out. Minus 3 plus 3 will give us 0. Similarly, we'll go for the next element, 3. Minus 3 by 2, this is 2. This will again cancel out, we'll get 0. And for the last element, 9 minus 3 by 2 into 6. Again, factors will cancel out and we get 0. Now, if you see, no more elementary operations can be performed. If we do so, the elements that are 0, that will be altered or they will become non-zero. The definition was number of linearly independent rows. Now, linearly independent rows are 2. So, the rank comes down to 2. Option B is correct. Let us move to the second example. Matrix, this is minus 4. Matrix with elements 2, minus 4, 4, minus 2 has, the options are, the given matrix has real eigenvalues and eigenvectors. Option B, real eigenvalues but complex eigenvectors. Third option, complex eigenvalues but real eigenvectors, and both eigenvalues and eigenvectors are complex. Now, if you see this given matrix, it is a skew symmetric matrix. And we know the eigenvalues of skew symmetric matrix are imaginary, or we can say complex. So, option C and D are valid. We directly have the rule that says they are complex eigenvalues, but there is no statement that gives us the result about eigenvectors. To find out whether the given matrix has real eigenvectors or complex eigenvectors, we need eigenvalues. So, in turn, however, we are supposed to find out the eigenvalue. We know how to find the eigenvalues. We have the characteristic equation, determinant of A minus lambda I is equal to 0, and roots of these equations are nothing but eigenvalues. So, let us find out the roots now. Substitute the given matrix, we will get 2 minus lambda minus 4, 4 minus minus lambda. Determinant of this is equal to 0. Let us find the determinant. 2 minus lambda minus 2 minus lambda plus 16 is equal to 0. Multiply both the brackets, we get minus 4 minus 2 lambda. This will get cancelled, and plus lambda square plus 16 is equal to 0. So, this will be lambda square is equal to 12, and lambda will be plus or minus 2 root 3i. Sorry, this is minus 12, otherwise the root wouldn't be natural. So, as first we had concluded that the for skew symmetric matrix, the eigenvalues are complex, and this is what we got, they are complex values. First, we will consider lambda equal to 2 root 3i and find out the eigenvector. We have for eigenvectors, we have A minus lambda I into x is equal to 0. Let us substitute the value of eigenvalue in the given determinant. This will be 2 minus 2 root 3i minus 4, 4 minus 2 minus 2 root 3i. This will be x1, x2 equal to 0. Let us solve this. This will give us 2 minus 2 root 3i x1 minus 4 x2 is equal to 0. 2 minus 2 root 3i x1 is equal to 4 x2. So, x1 x2 will be 2 minus 2 root 3. This is r. Now, if you see, the eigenvector is also complex. Anyway, if you consider the second equation as well, you are going to get the imaginary eigenvectors. This was for eigenvalue 2 root 3i. If you consider the negative eigenvalue, you are going to get the same result that says complex eigenvalues and complex eigenvectors. Hope you understood. Thank you. Thank you for your support till now. We'll need it more. So please like my video, share with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Thank you.